A very good morning, friends. Today's topic of discussion is important LAQ, that is mechanism of hormone action. Okay, all of you know the definition of hormone. Yes, hormones. These hormones are, they are chemicals secreted by endocrine glands. Generally, these glands, they are ductless glands, endocrine glands. And it has action on target tissues. Target tissues. These type of chemicals or substances, they are known as hormones. These hormones, they are classified on the basis of their mechanism of action. There are two main classification. The first one is the group 1 hormone. Group 1. And second class is the group 2 hormone. Group 2 hormones. Okay. It is based on their receptors. Okay. It is based on their receptors. If receptors are present intracellularly, intracellular receptors, they are known as group 1 hormones. And if receptors, they are present on cell membrane and mechanism is through second messenger, hormone is a first messenger. And if the receptors, they are present on cell membrane and mechanism of action is through the second messenger, these hormones belongs to group 2. These group 2 hormones, they are again divided into group A, B, C and D. Group A, B, C and D. If second messenger is cyclic AMP, it is group A. If it is cyclic GMP, it is group B. If it is calcium or inositol, phosphatidyl inositol, it is group 3, that is group C. And if it is through kinase and phosphatase cascade, it is group D. Okay. Group 2 A, B, C, D, cyclic AMP, cyclic GMP, calcium, phosphatidyl inositol and kinase cascade pathway. Okay. The hormone acting through these second messengers, they belongs to group 2. Now we'll see the basic difference between group 1 and group 2 hormones. These group 1 hormones, they are lipophilic in nature. And it is very, very important. They are lipophilic in nature. All of you know that cell membrane, it is a bilipid layer. So these hormones, that is group 1 hormones, they can easily traverse or easily pass through a cell membrane. Okay, they are lipid soluble, lipophilic in nature. Then they have long half-life in hours to days. Then they require transport molecule. In group 2 hormones, they are hydrophilic. They cannot traverse through a cell membrane. Hence their receptors, they are present on the cell membrane. Then say this after binding of hormone to the cell membrane receptor, they send a message which causes a cellular response. They are hydrophilic in nature. The short half-life in minutes. Then they do not require transport molecule. No transport molecule is required. is required. Then receptors, next difference is receptors, group 1 hormone, they having intracellular receptors. Group 2 hormone, they having receptor on their cell membrane, okay, cell membrane of target tissue. Then mediators, next difference is mediator. The group 1 hormone, they act by forming hormone receptor complex. And these hormones, they act through second messenger. So this is the basic difference between these two. As they are lipophilic, they can pass through a membrane and they act on intracellular receptor. They are hydrophilic, they cannot pass through a membrane. By attaching to the cell surface receptor, surface receptor, they activate the second messenger that causes the cellular response. Now coming to the examples of group 1 and group 2 hormones. Group 1 hormone, hormones, it includes steroid hormones, it is glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, androgens, progestin, estrogen, then calcitriol, vitamin D, that is calcitriol, thyroid hormone T3, T4, and retinoic acid. This is a mechanism of action of steroid hormone through a intracellular receptor by forming hormone receptor complex. Steroid hormones, group 1 hormones include steroid hormones, then it includes calcitriol, thyroid hormones and retinoic acid. Steroid hormones includes, these are the steroid hormones, glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, androgen, progestin and estrogen. Then other compounds, that is vitamin D, thyroid hormone and retinoic acid, they act, also act through intracellular receptors. Of these two, thyroid hormones and retinoic acid, they act on intranuclear receptors. This is a MCQ. Intranuclear, thyroid hormones and retinoic acid. Okay, this is about group 1 hormones. Now coming to the examples of group 2 hormones. Group 2. First, is the second messenger is through cyclic AMP. It includes mainly, it is a group 2A. Okay. A for adrenaline. Then second one is the glucagon. Adrenaline, glucagon. Then FSH, LH, MSH, ACTH, parathyroid hormone, calcitonin, somatostatin. They act through cyclic AMP. So these are the examples of group 2A, that is adrenaline, glucagon, follicle stimulating hormone, luteinizing hormone, melanocyte stimulating hormone, adrenocorticotropic hormone, parathyroid hormone, calcitonin and somatostatin and etc. So these are the some examples of hormones which act through second messenger cyclic AMP. Group 2A. Now coming to group 2B. It is very easy to remember group 2B through cyclic GMP. It includes nitric oxide, and atrial nitriuretic factor. Nitric oxide and atrial nitriuretic factors, they act through cyclic GMP. Then group 2C, when the second messenger is calcium or phosphatidyl inositol. Calcium or phosphatidyl inositol, it includes oxytocin, gonadotropin releasing hormone, gastrin, cholecystokinin, thyrotropin releasing hormone, platelet derived growth factor, substance P, muscarinic ACTH and alpha 1 catecholamines, adrenergic catecholamines. These are the examples of group 2C, that is through calcium and phosphatidyl inositol. Oxytocin, gonadotropin releasing hormone, gastrin, cholecystokinin, thyrotropin releasing hormone, platelet derived growth factor, substance P, muscarinic ACTH and alpha 1 adrenergic catecholamines. They act through calcium and phosphatidyl inositol. This alpha 2 adrenergic, they belongs to cyclic AMP, that is alpha 2 adrenergic catecholamines and beta adrenergic catecholamines, they belongs to cyclic AMP group 2A. Now the last one, that is group 2D, through kinase and phosphatase cascade, it includes growth hormone, epidermal growth factor, then prolactin and important one insulin. So you can take a snapshot here. These are the group 2 hormone A, B, C, D. This one is the A, B, C and D. A through cyclic AMP, B through cyclic GMP, C through calcium and phosphatidyl inositol, and D, it is through kinase cascade pathway. So these are the important examples of group 2 hormones. Now we'll see the sequence of events in the group 1 and group 2 hormones. Okay, in the hormone action, sequence of events. In group 1 hormones, group 1, first this hormone, it travels through a cell membrane and it binds with the intracellular receptor. So first one is the hormone receptor complex formation, intracellular complex formation of hormone receptor complex. Okay, second, binding of this hormone receptor complex to hormone responsive element. Okay, binding of hormone receptor complex to hormone responsive element. Third point is the activation, transcription and synthesis of protein, which is responsible for expression and biochemical response. So this is the events. First, they travel through a cell membrane, enters intracellularly, binds to the intracellular receptor, then binding of hormone receptor complex to hormone responsive element, activation of this responsive element lead to the transcription, production of mRNA, which leads to the production of appropriate protein, and expression of this appropriate protein leads to the biochemical response. This is a event, these are the events in the mechanism of action of group 1 hormones. While in group 2 hormone, the first they binds to the cell surface receptors, bind to cell surface receptors, okay, which leads to the activation of G protein, this activation of G protein leads to the activation of protein kinases, and activation of protein kinases leads to the formation of phosphoprotein, which is responsible for biochemical response. So these are the events in group 2 hormone mechanism of action. Okay, bind to cell surface receptor, activation of G protein, activation of protein kinase, phosphoprotein formation, and biochemical response. So this is group 1 hormone and group 2 hormone. Now we will discuss mechanism of action of group 1 hormones. Group 1 hormones. It acts through intracellular receptors by forming hormone receptor complex. Okay, so this is how group 1 hormones act. Okay, consider this is a cell membrane. This topic is best given in Harper's Illustrated Biochemistry, and all diagrams they are taken from Harper's Biochemistry. Okay, so this is a hormone or ligand. Okay, this is a hormone. Now it travels the cell membrane. This is a cell membrane. It is a nucleus. This is a nucleic acid, genetic material, DNA. Okay. Now this is a cell membrane. This hormone travels the cell membrane. As it is lipophilic in nature, it can easily pass through or easily traverse through a cell membrane. It enters into a cytoplasm where it encounters with its cognate receptor, which is attached to heat shock protein HSP, Now this is the hormone. Binding of hormone to a receptor causes conformational changes in the receptor molecule. This is a receptor molecule. After binding with hormone, and there is release of heat shock protein. This heat shock protein gets detached from the hormone. Okay. Now this hormone, it crosses the nuclear membrane, and it get attached with hormone responsive elements. This is hormone responsive element, or if it is a glucocorticoid, it is glucocorticoid responsive element. This receptor hormone complex get attached with a hormone receptor complex. This is hormone responsive element. Okay, and it activates number of factors. It activates number of factors which stimulates the transcription and translation process. after the activation of different factors, there is synthesis of mRNA by the process of transcription, and this from this mRNA there is synthesis of protein, and this protein shows his biochemical response, means action, biochemical effect or response. This is the mechanism of action of steroid hormone. Example, glucocorticoid. Suppose this is a glucocorticoid. It enters into the cell membrane as it is lipophilic, where they encounter with his cognate receptor, which is attached to heat shock protein. After binding of hormone to the receptor, causes conformational changes in the receptor molecule and release of heat shock protein. Then this receptor hormone complex enters into the nucleus. In nucleus, it binds with hormone responsive element or glucocorticoid responsive element, and it effect or it enhances the formation of various factors which stimulate the transcription process, and in translation there is synthesis of protein molecule, and this protein molecule will show his biochemical effect, and this is a mechanism of action of steroid hormone. This belongs to group 1 hormones. There are a number of examples of group 1 hormones. We already discussed that it includes glucocorticoids, mineralocorticoids, corticoids, then sex hormones, then calcitriol, T3, T4 and retinoic acid. Now we'll see the mechanism of action of T3, T4 and retinoic acid, which has intracellular receptor. Suppose this one is a retinoic acid or thyroid hormone, okay, which has intranuclear receptor. Okay, in this, what happens? They travels through a cell membrane as they are lipophilic in nature. They are now intracytoplasmic. Then they enters into a nucleus. Now they are intranuclear. Okay, now they are intranuclear. This is a DNA molecule. This is a hormone responsive element which is already attached with a receptor molecule, and one inhibitor is there which is attached to this receptor. On binding of this hormone to a receptor, this one is a receptor. Okay, an attachment of this hormone to a receptor causes release of this negative effector, and there are number of positive factors which get stimulated, and it causes the formation of mRNA and protein which causes biochemical response. This is a mechanism of action of thyroid hormone and retinoic acid. They having intranuclear receptor. So summarizing the mechanism of action of group 1 hormone, this is the mechanism of action of glucocorticoids. This is glucocorticoid, this is receptor, hormone receptor complex formation, binds to the hormone responsive element, transcription, translation and biochemical response. T3, T4 and retinoic acid, they have intranuclear receptor. They crosses the cell membrane, enters into the cytoplasm, then enters into the nucleus. In nucleus, they binds with the hormone responsive element. Negative effector get detached. They activates number of positive effectors, which causes transcription and translation and synthesis of protein, which shows biochemical response. This is a mechanism of action of group 1 hormone. This diagram is very, very important. Draw the diagram in your answer sheet and just enumerate the sequence of events, okay, one by one, and these are the examples of group 1 hormones. Now we will proceed towards the mechanism of group 2 hormones, that is group 2A hormone. Group 2A All of you know the sequence of events in the group 2 hormones. They first binds with the cell surface receptor. Okay. Then they causes release of second messenger. Then second messenger causes activation of protein kinases, and then protein kinases will activate the protein, converts the protein into phosphoprotein that will shows the biochemical response. Got it? So this is the sequence of event in group 2. It is through a G protein coupled receptor. Group 2 hormones, the mechanism is through G protein coupled receptor. Group 2 hormones, they binds with the cell surface receptor. Cell surface receptors. Okay. After binding with cell surface receptor, they causes activation of G protein. This G protein causes activation of protein kinases, and protein kinases will cause conversion of protein into phosphoprotein. Phosphoprotein, which will show physiological effect or biochemical response. Biochemical response. Response. This is the sequence of event in group 2 hormones. Of this, now G protein. What do you mean by G protein? G protein, it is a hetero trimeric protein. Okay. Now coming to a explanation of G protein coupled receptor. It has 7 transmembrane domain. Okay. It has 7 transmembrane domain. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It has 7 transmembrane domain. Okay. Okay. 7 transmembrane domain, and there is attachment of gamma subunit, beta subunit, and alpha subunit, which is GDP bound. GDP bound. This is a G protein. G protein. This is a receptor, G protein receptor, and this is a effector molecule. Effector molecule can be cyclic AMP, it can be phospholipase C, it can be calcium, and so on. Okay, got it. This is receptor, this is G protein, this is effector molecule. Effector molecule can be cyclic AMP, it can be phospholipase C, it can be calcium, it can be sodium, etc. Okay, on binding of hormone to the receptor, causes activation in the form of tilting of this 7 transmembrane domain. The tilting occurs, and as there is tilting occurs, there is due to the GTPase activity, there is separation of this alpha from beta gamma subunit. Now this becomes active. It is GTP bound and it becomes active. This active subunit will causes changes in the effector molecule, and that causes biochemical response. Got it? This is G protein coupled receptor in short. Okay. Now coming to the mechanism of action of group 2A hormone. Group 2A hormone, it is through cyclic AMP. Okay. This is plasma membrane. This is adenyl cyclase, which is an enzyme. Adenylyl cyclase. This can be an effector. Adenylyl cyclase can be an effector which is activated by a G protein. Now adenylyl cyclase will causes conversion of ATP into cyclic AMP, and this cyclic AMP can be converted into 5' AMP by the phosphodiesterase. Now this cyclic AMP act on protein kinase, which is composed of R2C2 unit. Okay, it is inactive protein kinase A. This cyclic AMP bounds with the R2 subunit, and it causes activation of protein kinase. This is C2 unit, it is catalytic unit, this is regulatory unit. Now it is activated. Now this activated unit causes conversion of protein into phosphoproteins. Phosphoprotein, which shows response, which shows response. Okay, and this is again converted into protein by the phosphatase. The response can be removed by the phosphatase and phosphodiesterase. Got it? Adenyl cyclase, which is an effector molecule activated by the G protein, causes conversion of ATP into cyclic AMP. Cyclic AMP activates protein kinase. Protein kinase causes phosphorylation of protein into phosphoprotein, which shows response. Response can be removed by phosphatase and phosphodiesterase. This is a mechanism of action through a cyclic AMP. You know the examples of group 2A hormones, adrenaline, glucagon, then FSH, LH, TSH, then melanocyte stimulating hormone, somatostatin, calcitonin. These are the examples of group 2A hormones. Okay, examples of it is adrenaline, glucagon, FSH, LH, TSH, melanocyte stimulating hormone, somatostatin, then calcitonin, etc. Got it? Now moving to the group 2, that is group 2B, that is through cyclic GMP. Now mechanism of action of group 2B, which is cyclic GMP, through cyclic GMP, which act as a second messenger. Examples, nitric oxide and atrial natriuretic factor. These are the examples. Okay. Now coming to the mechanism of action of group 2C hormones, that is through calcium, phosphatidyl inositol or both. Okay. So calcium, phosphatidyl inositol or both. In this hormone, it binds with the receptor which are present on the cell surface. Hormone binds with the receptor which causes activation of G protein, and G protein will activate phospholipase C. This is a effector molecule, phospholipase C. This is a membrane. Okay. This is a membrane. Attachment of hormone to receptor activates G protein, which activates phospholipase C. This phospholipase C causes conversion of phosphatidyl inositol bisphosphate to diacylglycerol and inositol triphosphate. Okay, diacylglycerol and inositol triphosphate. This G protein also increases the movement of calcium ions. Okay, now this DAG will activate protein kinase. It will activate protein kinase. IP3 causes release of calcium from endoplasmic reticulum. It causes release of calcium from endoplasmic reticulum. Now this calcium attached with the calmodulin to form calcium calmodulin complex. Calmodulin complex. This calcium calmodulin complex activates various calmodulin dependent kinases. Okay, they activate various specific kinases, and these kinases will causes conversion of protein into phosphoprotein. Protein into phosphoprotein, which will show its effect. Okay, these protein kinases, they can directly through diacylglycerol, they can directly convert this protein into protein kinases, and they will show effect. This calcium can also directly convert this protein into phosphoprotein, and this calcium and calmodulin complex can directly convert this protein into phosphoprotein and will show effect. So this is a mechanism of action of group 2C hormones, which includes oxytocin. It includes oxytocin, vasopressin, substance P, cholecystokinin, gastrin, muscarinic ACTH, and alpha-1 adrenergic catecholamines. So these are included into group 2C, and this is the mechanism of action. Once again I repeat, an attachment of hormone to receptor activates G protein, which will activate phospholipase C, which causes conversion of phosphatidyl inositol bisphosphate into diacyl glycerol and inositol triphosphate. The inositol triphosphate causes release of calcium from endoplasmic reticulum, which attaches to the calmodulin to form a calcium calmodulin complex, which activates number of calmodulin dependent kinases. Okay, these kinases will convert protein into phosphoprotein, and which will show the effect. This diacyl glycerol causes activation of protein kinase, which converts protein into phosphoprotein, and directly this calcium also converts this protein into phosphoprotein and will show its effect. This is a mechanism of action of group 2 C hormones. Now coming to the group 2 D, and it is a very important for postgraduate student, but we will see this topic, that is mechanism of action of group 2 D, for UG only. Okay, it is, we will not cover this topic in detail for postgraduate student, but we will cover this topic for UG students. Okay, the group 2 D means through kinases, kinase phosphatase cascade. Okay, so it includes mainly insulin, growth hormone. Okay, then prolactin, they act through group 2 D, means through kinase phosphatase cascade. This is insulin receptor. Okay, and this is tyrosine molecule, which is present on inner side of this receptor. Okay, this is insulin receptor. Once insulin get attached to it, on attachment of insulin to this receptor causes phosphorylation of this tyrosine. It has intrinsic tyrosinase activity, so it causes activation of this tyrosine molecule, intrinsic tyrosine molecule, which causes activation of insulin receptor substrate 1-4, which causes activation of insulin receptor substrate 1-4 by phosphorylation, again by the phosphorylation. Okay, and due to this phosphorylation of insulin receptor substrate, it causes activation of various protein kinases and also lipid kinases. This is in short discussion, lipid kinases. Okay, it also activates some factors, that is MSOS and GRB2, which shows its effect, biological effect. These various protein kinases and lipid kinases, they are involved in the activation of various kinases, and these kinases will show their effect in the form of protein translocation, activation of enzymes and transcription, translation, these factors, they also activates various kinases, atypical kinases, and they will shows the DNA synthesis, cell growth and early response. Okay, so this is the mechanism of action of insulin. So kinases phosphatase cascade, on binding of insulin to receptor causes activation of tyrosine molecule, which activates the insulin receptor substrate 1-4, which activates various proteins, that is MSOS, GRB2, mTOR. Activation of this protein will activates various protein kinases, which includes, that is PI3 kinases and PTEN, and they will show their response in the form of protein translocation, activation of enzyme, transcription, gene expression, DNA synthesis, cell growth and early response through various proteins. Okay, so this is a mechanism of action of insulin, Group 2D hormone, it includes growth hormone, then epidermal growth factor, epidermal derived growth factor, then prolactin, insulin, etc. So this is all about mechanism of hormone action. This is a very, very important topic. Read this topic from Harper's Illustrated Biochemistry. It is the best book for this topic. Okay, keep watching. Thank you.